everyone, it's me, Cece, and about a week ago, a YouTuber by the name of Amazingish Grace posted this video.
Now, I feel like people love the time restraint videos where it's like, I tried to do X thing in one day. So I figured this time, instead of trying to complete something in one day, I'm just gonna see how much I can do in one day. And I decided to make some granny squares.
Now, upon seeing this, instead of being like, wow, that's so amazing, oh my gosh, I'm so proud of her, I got competitive. The granny square is a staple in the crochet world. You can find thousands of projects using granny squares, using thousands of different variations of a granny square. So upon seeing Grace's video, I thought, I could totally do that. Could I? I started doing the math and I realized that if I set aside an entire day to crochet granny squares, I could probably beat her record. So I took a day to see how many granny squares I could crochet, and this unfortunately is not the final result. So this is my attempt at trying to beat Amazingish Grace's one day granny square record. Gosh, that took me way too long to say. So without further ado, let's go!
What's up, home slices? It's your girl, Cece.
It is 10:30 a.m. on this beautiful June day. And I technically have the day off today. I've got a couple of things around the house to do, but I think that today is the day that I am gonna try and granny square my butt off. So the number to beat right now is 41. That is what Grace did in her video. So it's 10:30 right now. If I do around about 4 granny squares every hour, so like 1 every 15 minutes, which is reasonable, I think, for me, that should get us there in 10 hours by like 8:30, give or take-ish. But I also have other things to do, so I'm giving myself until midnight, but I still, at a rate of 4 granny squares an hour, that should work, hypothetically. I'm gonna get started. Alright, I'm back wearing one of my crochet tops. I got 5 granny squares done in about an hour and a half, so a little bit slower than the pace we were expecting, but not horrible. Just one problem, I took a quick break to do dishes and laundry, but then I also needed to take a shower because I got dish water in my hair and that was gross, and I also needed to make lunch and a couple of fun drinky poos. So it is now 2:30 p.m. and I only have 5 granny squares done. It's 2:30 p.m. We only have 5 granny squares done. We are so behind schedule. So I'm gonna sit down for a couple of hours and crank some out, see if I can finish just enough for the one bag that I was thinking of making. Oh, let me show you what I actually made. These are the squares that I've made so far. I kind of gave up on trying to mix in these guys because it just did not work with these yarns over here, but I'm gonna make 8 of these. Just the two of these. Wait, that math ain't mathin'. 9 of these, 2 of these, 2 of these, and that should be 13 for that bag. After I'm done with that, I am going to try and make another one of those bags with some scratchy wool yarn that I got as a Christmas present. I have like 3 skeins of it, but it's so uncomfy, I don't know what to do with it. Maybe try to whip out some granny square bandanas and maybe start the hexagon granny cardigan moment, maybe. If I do end up going to the granny hexagon cardigan, I probably will not do like a whole bunch of rows. I don't know how I would count that if I were to do that, but we're gonna try our darndest. All right, besties, we've got good news and we've got bad news. Good news, we have 13 squares, which means that we can technically make a bag out of this. The bad news is it is 7 p.m. and I've only done 13 squares. Things aren't looking good for me. I still have to finish organizing my room and like putting everything back together. We moved a table out of here, so now there's a big blank space by Taylor Swift. There's a massive space there and I need to move things around. There's a table over there that I want to move into there, and then the bed I want to turn and tuck it into the wall so that it's like a dorm room style bed. Anyway, she's a little bit scattered. I've been watching MCC Pride, Pearlescent Moon's POV. I'm gonna keep doing that. I'm gonna organize my room, and then there's no way I'm making 41 granny squares today. So what I'm gonna do instead is I am going to try and make like 1 granny square bandana, and then I'm gonna get started on the crochet cardigan. And I think it's gonna be super cool, super neat. I'm looking forward to it, And I think we're gonna get a lot done today, regardless of whether or not we actually beat Grace's record, which isn't really a record because she wasn't really trying that hard. Jesus Christ, 41 when you're not even trying that hard. Who is she? All right, I'm gonna get to work. Okay, so I think that this is gonna be the last update of this video. So as you could probably guess, I did not get a whole lot done that last night, but I did get a little bit further on the granny hexagon cardigan, and this is what I managed to crank out. Now, I'm not sure how much to actually count this as because one, this is a hexagon, not a square, which means that there are two extra sides for me to crochet, and two, I did a lot more than four layers here, which means that that's a lot of squares. So I'm gonna count this as like three. I'm gonna be generous because honestly, I need it. My final tally is 13 on the back, which I stitched together. I wanna show you guys because it's really cute. All right, I got it. This is it. This is a little guy. Look at it. I'm gonna add a little handle on like right here in between the two like peak corners of the squares, but it's like a little cute purse tote moment. I'm a fan of it. So this is 13 plus the three squares that we did here, three in big quotes, which I can't do because my hands are full. 13 plus 3 is 16, which is a little pathetic. I got my butt whooped. So now I need to go on a whole training arc in order to get better at crochet, and that's gonna be like at least a couple of seasons. Do I want to do a part two on this video? I don't know. Either way, I'm in desperate need of a training arc, so thank you, Grace, for kicking my butt. Make sure to check out Grace's original video, which will be linked somewhere in one of the places in the cha-cha-cha or the cha-cha-cha. Like this video, comment what you would have done better, and subscribe to see more of my lovely face. And I will see you in the next video. Goodbye!